Hello children, how are you all? I'm very happy to see you, meet you all through this video. Okay, before we could start our class, shall we pray? Close your eyes. Our merciful Father, we thank you for the session, Lord. Thank you for being with us. Thank you for guiding us. Thank you for protecting us, Lord. Thank you for all the blessings, Lord. Lord, thank you for the new year. Lead us and guide us, Lord, according to thy will and wish. Especially, Lord, as the students are going to watch the video, be with them and guide them, give them good understanding power to understand the portion well. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, listen, children. We have entered into a new term, third term. Our first chapter is chapter 1. Fraction. We are going to learn about fraction. Fraction means what? First you should know that. Fraction means what? In 5th standard you would have learned this. Fraction means what? Fraction means numerator by denominator. Numerator by denominator. Okay. What is numerator? What is denominator? It denominator means the whole part. For example, here I am having a circle. Okay, I divided the circle into 4 parts. How many parts? 4 parts. Okay, so this 4 is denominator. This 4 is denominator, whole part. Numerator, how many parts are shaded here? 2 parts. So that 2 is denominator, numerator. Understood now? Understood everybody? Yes. So fraction means what? Numerator by denominator. Understood? You have learned so much things here about equivalent fractions, about comparison of fractions. We are going to learn now. Understood, children? Okay, first, what is called equivalent fraction? How to read the numbers which I am writing here? Okay, this we say half, this we say what? Half. This how to read? 1/3, 1/4, 1/5, 1/6, like this it goes on. Okay, suppose 2/3 means how you'll read this? 2/3. 4/5 means 4/5. Okay, like this we have to read it. Okay, now I'm going to teach about equivalent fraction now. Equivalent fraction. Before we could go, we could see the equivalent fraction, I want to tell you about proper fraction and improper fraction. Okay, proper fraction and improper fraction. Proper fraction and improper fraction. Then mixed fraction. These 3 I want to tell you, I want to teach you. What is called proper fraction? What is called improper fraction? What is called mixed fraction? Okay, proper fraction means always the numerator will be greater than the denominator. 1 minute. Okay, listen here. Proper fraction means always the numerator will be lesser. Okay, numerator will be lesser. See, 2 is lesser, 3 is greater. 4 is lesser, 5 is greater. 6 is lesser, 7 is greater. Okay, this, when the numerator is smaller than the denominator, it is called proper fraction. In the same way, when the numerator is greater than the denominator. See, 5 is greater, 4 is lesser. Okay, and 2 or 4/3, 7/5. See, these all are greater than their denominators. Okay, so it is called improper fraction. Okay, how to write the mixed fraction? We are going to frame mixed fraction from improper fraction only. How? When we divide the improper fraction, we get mixed fraction. Here, let me divide and show you. 5/4 I am taking for example. 5 I am dividing by 4. How many fours are there in 5? 1 fours are 4, remainder 1. Okay. This I am going to write as mixed fraction means it can, numerator by denominator can be written as quotient remainder by divisor. What is quotient? The answer which we get here is called quotient. The number which we get as remainder. Okay. Is remainder. This is what? Divisor. So, what is quotient here? Quotient is 1. What is remainder? 1. What is divisor? 4. Understood? Mixed fraction is derived from improper fraction only. Okay. Improper fraction means what I said? Numerator will be greater, denominator will be lesser. So, I am dividing 5 by 4. 1 fours are 4, remainder 1. So, the answer which I am getting here is called quotient. The remainder is 1. This is called divisor. So, I am writing here. So, quotient is 1, remainder is 1, divisor is 4. So, mixed fraction is 1, 1 by 4. Mixed fraction of 5 by 4 is what? 1, 1 by 4. Understood? Yes. Next, I am going to teach you what? Equivalent fraction. Okay, suppose I am having a fraction here, 2 by 3. 2 by 3. There. Okay, let us find 3 equivalent fraction of 2 by 3. They may ask you to find out 5 or 7 or 2 or 1. But here we are going to find 3 equivalent fractions of 2 by 3. Okay. Nothing. Whatever the fraction is written here, you write here. As it is, you write. Whatever the fraction. Then multiply by this is what? 2 ones are 1. 3 ones are 3. So next number is what? 2. Multiply numerator and denominator with the same number 2. Next you multiply the numerator and denominator with the same number. Okay. Next here 2 ones are 2. 2 twos are. 2 threes are. Next is what? 2. 4s are, so here also 3 4s are. Suppose if they ask you to find another number means 3 5s are. Next 3 6s are. Okay, like that we are multiplying with the tables. Okay, so 2 by 3. What is given here? 2 2s are 4 by 3 2s are 6. Let me erase this and tell you. I will write afterwards this one. Okay. 2 2s are 4. 4 by 3 2s are 6 is equal to 2 3s are 6, 3 3s are 9, 2 4s are 8, 3 4s are 12. Okay, understood now? So 2 by 3 is equal to 2 2s are 4, 4 by 6, 2 3s are 6, 6 by 9, 2 4s are 8 by 3 4s are 12. Understood everybody? This is called equivalent fractions. Next, I am going to teach you about like fractions. Okay. Like fraction means what? Like fractions means the denominator will be same. All the denominators will be same. Unlike fractions means it means the denominators will not be same. For example, here I am taking 3 by 5, 2 by 5, 6 by 5, 8 by 5. See here. My denominators are 5, 5, 5, 5, 5. But here, numerator may differ. Okay? Numerator may differ, but the denominators are same here. It is called like fraction. Understood, children? Like fraction means what? The denominators will be same. The numerator may be different. But in unlike fractions, okay, you see here, unlike fraction means what? The denominators differs here. Okay, here these two are like fractions because 5 and 5, but 2 and 9 are not like fraction. They are unlike fractions. Understood, children? So like fractions means what? The denominators will be same. Unlike fractions means the denominator will be same. Will not be same. Suppose if they give many fractions and they ask you to find the unlike fractions and the like fractions means you must check the denominators. Here 5, here 5. So these both are like fractions. These both are not like fractions. That is unlike fractions. Understood everybody? Okay. Children, we have four basic operations. Addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. You know that is it. To do addition and subtraction in fraction, we must compare the given fractions. We must compare the given fraction. So, comparison of fractions. Suppose two different fractions are given. How? Let me take 2 by 3 and 4 by 5. Two different fractions here. How many? Two different fractions I have written, written here. Okay. We must compare the denominator. First, we have to make C whether the denominators are same or not. First, we must see whether the denominators are same or not. Here 3, here 5, both are not same. So, we must make the denominators to be same. How to write? For that, either we can take LCM. If many fractions are given, we can take LCM. If like this, only two fractions are given, means easy way is, you multiply the first fraction with the second denominator. What is the second denominator? 5. Okay. What is the, then the second fraction multiply by the first denominator. What is it? 3. Understood? How to compare the fractions I am teaching here. Two fractions are given here. 2 by 3, 4 by 5. So, I am multiplying first fraction 2 by 3 with the second denominator. Okay, aware in both numerator and denominator. Likewise, second fraction I am multiplying with the first denominator, that is 3, up and down, numerator and the denominator. Now you see 10 by 15, 2 5s are 10, 3 5s are 15, 4 3s are 12, 5 3s are 15. Now you see the denominator became same. Now easily we can compare. 10 is greater or 12 is greater. 10 is greater, 12 is greater. 12 only greater. So, 12 by 15. Since 12 is greater, from where we get 12? From the fraction 5, 4 by 5. Therefore, 2 by 3 is lesser than 4 by 5. Understood everybody? Okay, this is comparison of fraction. How to do addition and subtraction? How to do addition and subtraction? To do addition and subtraction, in the same way, we must first check or we must compare the denominator and we must make the denominator to be same, both the, whatever the fractions given, whether two fractions or three fractions, whatever, how many fractions are given there, by taking LCM or by multiplying like this, you have to make the denominators to be same. Okay, now let me add and show you this. First one, addition. Okay, first we have to write like this. Okay, let me do addition here only. Okay, addition 2 by 3 and 4 by 5. 2 by 3 are multiplied here, 4 by 3 multiplied with the say first denominator. Now, what is the answer we got? 10 by 15. Addition means what? We must add. Add now plus 12 by 15. Since both the denominators are same, write the denominator as it is directly. Because both are same. So, you write as it is. Now, you add this 10 plus 12. So, 10 plus 12 means what will come? 22 by 15. 22 by 15 is the answer. When we add two fractions, first we must check whether the denominators are same or not. If the denominators are same, we can write the denominator as 1 and write the numerators and add the numbers. Suppose if we don't have the denominator as same number, we must make it as same. How? By multiplying the denominators. By multiplying each fraction with another fraction denominator. First fraction with a second fraction denominator. Second fraction with the first fraction denominator multiplied here. Understood? This is the way to do addition. Children, next subtraction. Okay? to do subtraction, we must compare the denominators, whether it is same or not. Here we don't have same denominator. Okay, so how to do now? So 3 by 4, they are asking you to subtract 3 by 4 from 6 by 7. So after from whatever comes, the second fraction only we must write first. We should not write 3 by 4 minus 6 by 7. It is wrong. Okay, after from whatever comes, only that we should write first. So 6 by 7 minus 3 by 4. Are we having same denominator? No, we don't have same denominator. So let's convert this. We'll make it as same. So 6 by 7. Here 3 by 4, operation is minus. Okay, multiply the first fraction with the second denominator. Second and 4. So, up and down 4. Yeah, multiply the second fraction with the first denominator. It is what? 7. So, what will come now? 6 fours are? 6 fours are? 24. 7 fours are? 28. Minus. 3 sevens are 21 divided by 4 sevens are 28. See, now it became as like fraction. The denominators are same here. Understood? So we'll move to the next one. Next step. What is the next step? Since the denominators are same, I am writing it as for both. I am writing for one time 28. This one I can subtract directly. So 24 minus 21. 24 minus 21 is what? What? 3 by 28. 24 minus 21 is 3. 3 by 28 is the answer. Understood everybody? Like this we have to do subtraction. Next, I am going to teach multiplication. Addition we finished, subtraction we finished. Okay. Next, it what? Multiplication. We'll take any number. I am taking one sum from our exercise. That is 3 by 8 multiplied by 4 by 5. Okay. 3 by 8 multiplied by 4 by 5. Now, you see here. 3 by 8 multiplied by 4 by 5. How to multiply? For multiplication and division, no need to check the denominator whether it is same or not. It can be different. Okay. Only for addition and subtraction you should check. Now, so what to do for multiplication? Directly you can multiply. 3 4s are 8 5s are. One way. 3 4s are 12. 8 5s are 40. Okay, if you divide by 2, what will come? This is what? 2 6 are 12. This can be 2 20 are. So 2 and 2 cancel. So your answer will be 6 by 20. Again, you can divide this. This can be written as what? 2 divided by 3. This can be 2 divided by 10. 2 and 2 cancel. So 3 by 10. So your final answer is what? 3 by 10. This is one way, multiplying directly and writing. When you multiply, if it is small number, smaller means the answer will be easy for you. Suppose the numbers are in 2-digit number or 3-digit number, means how you will multiply and do like this, it will be hard for you. So, for that, you can cancel it here in the first step itself. Let me keep the answer here to show you. So, you can cancel here itself. How to cancel? You see whether any common is there or not between the denominators and the numerators. Okay. Here you see anywhere, whether the first fraction or the second fraction, or if suppose another fraction is given, we can compare that. Okay. Only thing is we have to cancel the denominator and the numerator, not the numerator and the numerator, or denominator and the denominator. We must cancel numerator with the denominator or denominator with the numerator. Okay. Here you see. 1 4s are 4, 2 4s are 8. Okay. 1 4s are 4, 2 4s are 8. Any other common are we having here? 3 is there. Any multiplication of 3? No. 2 is here. Any multiplication of 2? No. 5 is here. Any multiplication of 5 here? No. So, hereafter we cannot cancel that. So, I am multiplying it. 3 1s are 3, 2 5s are 10. See the answer? 3 by 10, 3 by 10. Understood, children? So, if the smaller numbers or bigger number, if you have possibility to cancel the number, first you cancel, then you write the answer. So, it will be easy for you. Okay, children? This is the way to do multiplication. Suppose, okay, one number is given. Four by five multiplied by six. How you do this? Fraction means you should have denominator, numerator, and the denominator. Here I am having only one number. That means what? It is divided by one. Always you should keep in mind, if there is a whole number, means it is multiplied by one and denominator divided by one. How? 1 6 are six. In the same way, 6 by 1 also 6. So, this is what? 1 you should take. So, 4 6 are 24. 5 1s are 5 is the answer. Understood? And we can write this in mixed fraction also. How to write 24 divided by 5? How many 5s are there in 24? 4 5s are 20. 24 minus 20 is 4. So, first we must write the quotient remainder by divisor. What is quotient? 4. What is remainder? 4. What is divisor? 5. Okay, this is the way to, even you can find out this mixed fraction in from the answer of addition and subtraction also. Okay, we must bring the answer into simplest form. After that, we should not, it should not get cancelled by any other number. Like that, we have to bring it out to the lowest form. Next, division. Next is what? Division. Multiplication we finish. Next is what? Division. Okay. I am taking fraction here. 4 by 5 divided by 8 by 20. 4 by 5 is divided by 8 by 20. Okay. If they give like this, write the first fraction as it is. Write the first fraction as it is. Change the division symbol into multiplication symbol. Listen carefully. You have to listen here. Very, very important point here. Write the first fraction as it is, 4 by 5. And change or convert the division symbol to multiplication. For the second fraction, you write denominator as numerator, numerator as denominator. Here 8 by 20, 20 by 8. This is a very, very important step in division. If you understand this, surely you can do that. Rest are same like multiplication only. This is the very, very important step. After changing the symbol, we have to write the reciprocal of the second fraction. Reciprocal means what? Talakila eludhurudhu. Okay? Numerator denominator avum, denominator numerator avum eludhanum. So here 8 by 20, I am writing it as 20 by 8. Now rest all the steps are like how we did multiplication, no? Same like that. So 1 4s are 4, 2 4s are 8. Are you understanding? 1 4s are 4, 2 4s are 8, 1 5s are 5, 4 5s are 20. Again 1 2s are 2, 2 2s are 4. So what is the answer? 1 2s are 2, 1 1s are 1, that is equal to 2. Understood everybody? Okay, this is the way to understand, this is the way to do the steps. Now we have completed all the four basic operations. Okay, using this only, exercise 1.1 is there. Okay, I taught how to do. So, I will be sending the sums as PDF or as a photocopy. You copy down that. Okay. Suppose if you don't understand anything, you can call me and ask. Okay. I hope you all understood. I will not be repeating this. So, whenever I teach here, you listen. Okay, children. I have taught you how to do addition, subtraction, multiplication and division, and how to compare the fractions, how to find out the like fraction, then the fractions, how to write the mixed fractions, is it? Suppose if you have any doubt, you can ask me. I have taught the methods, okay, how to do exercise 1.1. So you try. Take your children, stay safe at home, don't play anywhere, obey your parent, do all the sums, whatever I tell you in the video, whatever I give you in the Zoom class, everything you finish up. Okay, children? Bye. Take care, children.